no time for questions, but thank you for coming in.
Thank you.
John, sorry, I you were sitting so quietly up there, I missed you.
Next time you want a sign on my fence at election time.
Yeah. Right. My name's John Allen. I live on Cranford Street. Did I make a submission on the draft plan? Couldn't be bothered. What do I get from my council's $1,350 per quarter or my $5,400 a year rates bill that I'm getting? I've been flooding on Inchwood Road since 1963. A new motorway, dual carriage lane down Cranford Street with speeds clocked by police of traffic at travelling at excessive 90k when coming off the motorway. Cyclists injured down the Cranford Street cycle lane and taken to hospital with a concussion after reporting the previous Thursday to the community board that the safety order of the road when tabled was a draft, then again swept under the carpet by staff when I said I wanted to have a talk with them. I'm getting congestion on Northcote Road and Main South Road outside the new Pack and Save to the point that traffic takes four or five changes to get through the intersection. No ability to bring to the attention of council or misconduct of staff or to be critical of councillors. A stadium on the road to nowhere with a $30 million roading shortfall. A councillor elected by 2,000 votes with the potential of 14,000 voters when approached cannot get a 2-minute park outside a shop on Cashel Street for his customers to shop. That the owner is now considering closing and thinks it's okay to spend $1 million on Gloucester Street because it's free money. Councillors that walk out because the staff are criticised for not doing their job by submitter. I've been watching submissions from the community garages and everybody's having their hand out, all right? Saying the council must attract events to the city, but I find it incredulous that public money is put into private enterprise and is being spent on the public purse for their benefit. If I want investment in my private business that I own from the council, I don't get access to public money to subsidise my private business. What I do want, I want clean water, sewerage, rubbish collection, and a roading network that works for all road users. I recently read a report from 1996 to 2000 saying the city needs to invest $160 million in water pipes and drainage. And this is a draft plan that's being addressed at the moment. It's completely inadequate. You need to retrench and focus on governments, not political ideology. In the year $2,000, the pipes that then were expecting either $500 to $1,300 per metre. How on earth is this going to now be thrust upon the city? Where has the government been from the city CEOs of the last 24 years? These people have been highly paid to run and look after our infrastructure, to the point it's been so badly run down it's almost criminal. Sell assets like the convention centre and the stadium. Divest the city of stuff that does not bring in an income for the city. Cut staff members. Cut wages of those earning over 100k in the staff and spend more money on maintaining infrastructure. Allow the public to comment on public meetings when posted on YouTube, both the good and the bad. If you find it offensive, resign. We can have a by-election. Free speech at a public meeting is vital. And to the councillors that stayed and took the good with the bad when the lawyer, Storm McVeigh, criticised staff, resign. So to summarise on this, I'm from Generation X. I don't care about feelings. I don't care about if things are not politically correct. But what I do want is a low rates, and to the point where I think bring in commissioners because you're not doing your jobs of governments. That's it.
Okay, we've got time for Tyler, please, and then Aaron, and then that'll do. We've got you there, mate.
Yep. Kia ora, John. Thanks so much for that. I've just got a question around the levels of service, and in this. Sorry, my assistant's talking in the background. I've got a question around levels of service, particularly with staff, and you're talking about consenting numbers in your submission. And I'm wondering, what would you do to increase the performance of council, particularly in that consenting area?
I think all the community boards should receive a budget, and they and the community decide on where money is spent. That is critical to get people on board to support you. When you have a mandate, then you have the right to govern. But when people are elected with the possibility of 14,000 votes and only 4,000 voters actually vote, that's a failing democracy. That's no ability to government with a mandate. It's being apathetic to the people of Christchurch because they can't get their view across. You know, it is critical to take the good with the bad. I have in my own electorate, I know Pauline works incredibly hard. I know Sarah works incredibly hard. But the thing is that they participate. They come along to meetings. I see them actually pushing it. And again, with Aaron as well. So, you know, you should be there as governance, not pushing a particular agenda. It's what the community wants. It's our money.
Thank you, Aaron. And lastly, Aaron, because he has hand up.
Yeah, I'll be really quick. You live on Cranford Street.
Mm-hmm.
Should that pass Innes be two lanes of traffic or the bus lane?
Ah.
You live there.
Well, we as residents actually wanted the bus lane all the way through to the roundabout because I remember speaking with the Selwyn mayor at the time saying that park and ride would be an essential contribution to reducing the traffic numbers. What's happened to it? What we got is a bus lane that's not working. You want a bus lane that's actually all the way from Sherbourne Street at the intersection of Beeley Ave all the way to the roundabout. And it has a bus lane priority so that people in the Selwyn district can park and ride their cars and they don't have to bring them in the city.
WiMAC.
Yeah. WiMAC, yeah, sorry.
Brilliant. Brilliant, John. Thank you very much for making the time.
No worries.